sound and echo.
As mentioned in part one, heart failure divided in two categories, systolic and diastolic. In systolic, we have pumping problem, and in diastolic, feeling problem. In other words, in diastolic dysfunction, left ventricular becomes stiffer and blood go hardly to the left ventricular. In that case, with progressing diastolic dysfunction, finally, left atrium pressure increased. Increasing left atrium pressure transport to the pulmonary venous, that at capillary level in lung, it causes high hydrostatic pressure. And result of that is interstitial edema and alveolar edema. That is the reason for symptom sign of shortness of breath in diastolic dysfunction. The normal mean left atrial pressure or filling pressure is about 8 to 10 millimercury. In diastolic dysfunction, it goes higher than this. Changes in diastolic dysfunction follow a specific pattern in Doppler. As you see here in this chart, at the left column is normal, and the other three are different degree of diastolic dysfunction. In early stage of diastolic dysfunction, the relaxation of left ventricular decreased. So it relaxed a little with delay that we will see here with become increasing IVRT or isovolumetric relaxation time. And the blood flow to the left ventricular slow. So the E drop. And it takes more time to fill completely. So E become wider, or in other words, deceleration time increased. And with atrial contraction, since at early diastolic dysfunction, as you see here, all the blood didn't go to the left ventricular. Some blood remained at the end of the early diastolic. So at atrial contraction, blood go faster to the left ventricular and cause A taller than usual. Even though in this phase of atrial contraction, pressure in atrial goes higher than normal, but generally mean left atrial pressure, mean left atrial pressure stay in the normal range and doesn't increase. That's the reason with this stage of the diastolic dysfunction, we called it impaired relaxation, and left atrial pressure will be normal. With progressing diastolic dysfunction, not only relaxation has problem, expansion of the left ventricular has problem too and become harder. In other words, left ventricle becomes stiffer. So with that change, little by little, blood retention in the left atrium and for pushing the blood goes to the left ventricular, pressure increased. With this increasing pressure in the left atrium, E start goes again higher because pressure goes higher when diastolic start, blood go faster. So start again, E goes higher and become shorter and deceleration decrease. And in one, when established diastolic dysfunction, the IVRT and deceleration time goes to the normal range and E become taller, but compared to the normal, if we evaluate the same patient, E become taller than normal. Here we have cutoff for 50 centimeter per second. So E become taller than 50 centimeter per second. In that case, left atrial pressure goes higher than normal, and we will call it abnormal. And this is stage two or pseudo-normal. With progressing diastolic dysfunction, the left atrial pressure goes higher, and so for, result is taller E and narrower E wave. So deceleration decreased and E velocity increased. in one point, E velocity become two times the A or even more. The same pattern changes happen to the pulmonary vein Doppler. In the early diastolic dysfunction, early stage in impaired relaxation, since the blood flow at the E early diastolic decreased, so the blood flow from pulmonary vein to the left atrium decreased too. That is correspond with the D wave. We will see D become shorter. With increasing right atrial pressure and worsening diastolic dysfunction, at this when pressure goes high in left atrium with starting diastole, early diastole, blood rush very fast to the left ventricular, so the blood pressure at the E point drop suddenly, and this drop suddenly pressure in left atrium, blood from pulmonary vein to the left atrium increased, and you will see again D increase even more than normal and become higher than S wave. And we continue worsening diastolic function. In one point, D become very higher than S wave. The same and AR wave is represent A atrial contraction. So we will see the same when A increased, AR increased to little by little become taller. On tissue Doppler, at the beginning, E at the early stage, E prime affect a lot and decrease more than A prime. So E prime to A prime become reversed. With progressing diastolic function, diastolic dysfunction, E prime and A prime become less or reverse, and both of them decrease velocity. Their velocity decrease as you see here. Now let's see the new guideline. Based on the new guideline on diastolic dysfunction evaluation, we can divide the patient in three groups. First, those patients that has serious pathology, including moderate to severe valvular disease like MR or MAC, mitral annulus calcification, serious arrhythmias like atrial fibrillation, tachycardia, bundle branch block, heart transplant, restricted cardiomyopathy, hypertrophic cardiomyopathy, cardiac pulmonary hypertension, or other situation like the patient is under ventilation or is very critical, like the patient in septic shock. In those cases, the evaluation of the diastolic function will be a little complex, and we are not going to talk about this in this lecture. In another lecture, we go in detail. The other two groups are those patients with normal left ventricular ejection fraction and low ejection fraction. The cutoff for normal ejection fraction in this category is EF equal or more than 50%, not 53 to 55%. In the patient with normal EF, we go evaluate four parameters or variable: average E to E prime, septal and lateral E prime velocity, TR velocity, and left atrial volume index. Average E to E prime is when we measure both medial and lateral E prime. If we use only medial E prime for this ratio, cutoff will be 13. If we use lateral E prime velocity, cutoff will be 15. For septal E prime velocity, cutoff is 7, and for lateral is 10. If any of these two meet this criteria, we take it as positive parameter. For TR, we use cutoff 2.8 meter per second. The reason we use this level, because at this velocity, pulmonary arterial systolic pressure become upper limit normal, and increasing over this amount, we will have pulmonary pressure, high pulmonary pressure. Now, if among of these four parameters, three of them is positive, patient has diastolic dysfunction. If three of them are negative, only one positive, patient has normal diastolic function. If two of them positive and two negative, it cannot be determined if the patient has diastolic dysfunction or not. We call it indeterminate and is inconclusive. When we found patient those has diastolic dysfunction, for grading, we go to the next step. In this step, that we can use it for the first group and those patients that have low ejection fraction. As we mentioned in the first part, almost all patients with low ejection fraction, they have some degree of diastolic dysfunction. That is the reason in this diagram, we don't see any normal diastolic function at this evaluation. So this mitral inflow, which check it for two parameters, ETA and E velocity. Based on that, if ETA is equal or more than two, and the patient is not athletic and young, this patient has severe diastolic dysfunction or type 3, and left atrial pressure is very high. If ETA prime is less than 0.8, and E velocity is less than 50 centimeters per second, patient has diastolic dysfunction type 1. Means we have impaired relaxation, but left atrial pressure will be normal. In this group of patients, if the patient are symptomatic, they have, for example, shortness of breath during activity or any other symptom related to the heart failure, we have to check it for coronary artery disease, or we go for doing more study, including diastolic stress test. Now, if the patient doesn't go to any of these two group, we go evaluated three other parameters. If two of them are positive, patient has diastolic dysfunction type 2 or pseudonormal. If the two of these three are negative, patient has diastolic dysfunction type 1. If we don't have TR, that many patients doesn't have TR, we check it the other two. If both of them are positive, patient has diastolic dysfunction type 2. If both of them are negative, patient has diastolic dysfunction type 1. If it's one of them positive or negative, then we go check the other parameters. The most important parameters in this case will be ratio S to D. If S is less than D, patient has high left atrial pressure and goes to category of grade 2. Now, let's put it in more practical way. As rule of thumb, all patients that has low ejection fraction or they have E prime less than A prime, always we have a kind of the diastolic dysfunction. Rule two, if E to A is taller than A, and E prime is taller than A prime, and E to E prime is less or equal 14, patient has normal diastolic function. If E to E prime is less than normal, and E prime less than A prime here, and E velocity is less than 50, we have grade 1 or impaired relaxation, and left atrial pressure is normal. If E to A goes to the normal range, we have two options. First, we can go to do Valsalva maneuver. in Valsalva maneuver during strain phase, if E to A become reverse or E to A ratio decrease more than 50%, this will be positive and patient will have pseudo normal diastolic dysfunction. If we don't do that or it wasn't conclusive, we go and check this other, these three parameters. If two of them is positive, grade 2. If two of them are negative, grade 1. If we don't have TR, then we go again, repeat those two other factors, two positive, grade 2, one, two negative, grade 1. If it's one negative, one positive, again, we go check it, other parameter, including S to D ratio. And final rules is when E to A is more than 2 and E prime is less than 7 centimeter, patient has diastolic dysfunction type 3 and left atrial pressure is very high. Or in those patients that has other character of finding of diastolic dysfunction, we see S to D ratio. If it's less than 40% or AR duration, AR duration minus A duration here is more than 30 milliseconds differences between AR and A duration, we will have diastolic dysfunction type 3. Up to next time, have a wonderful time.